Hello everyone, and welcome back to a brand new quick tip by JANUS Engineering. If you have been following our channel, previously you may have seen a video displaying how to get into narrow places on a turning part. We recently got asked if it is possible to create something similar to that video, but in a milling manner. This will be that demonstration. If you were present at the Hermle Open House 2022 this year, you may have seen out our Spartan helmet. As always, there were some challenges with this demonstration when creating the part, and we're going to work on one of them today. To begin, we are going to demonstrate one of the operations that create the helmet. When I click on the operation, you see that the tool I am using is quite long and must reach into quite a deep geometry in the helmet. If you look at the toolpath itself, it appears to be okay. But when we restart the simulation, side note, make sure that all of these boxes up here are checked. We will then see its natural or actual behavior when we start the simulation. When I start the replay, the tool is being put into the spindle. Then it heads to the starting point, and it is followed by a crash between the tool and the workpiece itself. If we continue after this point in the operation, it looks quite good. But also, the retraction is also going to hit the part itself. So, how can we fix this? We finish the simulation, then we will right-click on this operation, go to Object, followed by Start Events. The start event that I'm looking for is called Go To. We'll scroll down through the user-defined events and find it. Once we find it, we simply add the new event, and then the dialog box will appear. It's going to ask us what conditions we want before we actually begin the operation. I want to add a movement to a certain point, and then the point needs to be defined in a specific place. For example, we select this point right here on the helmet. Then we will add an offset option. This offset option for us is going to be in a rectangular. We will then set the offset in the Z direction to 100 millimeters, and followed by an offset in the Y direction of 50 millimeters. We don't just want to define the point. We are also going to want to define the tool axis itself by picking a vector. The vector is supposed to be in this direction, so we then select it, and then we select OK, and now I have added that very first point for the start event. There's also the option to add multiple defined points, so I will now add a new event. This point will be in the same spot as we selected before, and again, we will offset the point in 100 millimeters in the Z direction. This time, we want the point to be in the middle of that helmet, so we'll use a different value for Y, and this time, it's going to be negative 100. Then we select the tool axis. For this vector, we want it to be upward. We can click on that and then click OK out of these dialog boxes and start the verification of the toolpath. We first see that the tool is being displayed in a tilted manner here. Then the second point, we see that the tool is going upwards how it is supposed to be. After the second point, the actual operation will begin to begin manufacturing the part. The nice thing about these tools, not only can the start event be defined this way, but we can also create an end event for that as well. If we pick the end event, we will once more go into this dialog box. We're going to find the go to event, and we are going to add this as an event. We'll select that point, the same one as before, and we are going to do another offset in a rectangular manner. We're just going to do this in the Z direction this time, and then we can click OK. The tool axis does not matter this time. We will then add another event as well. This time we will use the offset to be set to Z100 and then 50 in the positive Y. When looking at this, it does not seem as far as I'd like it to be, so I'm going to change it to 80 millimeters instead. Then we're going to click OK and OK again. and then we'll select OK out of the dialog box. When I check out the tool verification now, I see it is tilting from the side into the helmet, then moving out of the helmet so that the tool is free to go back into the storage without colliding. We can now check out the NC code simulation. When I click Simulate Machine, the NC code will now be displayed to the right, and I will click Play up at the top. The tool is being picked, and now before the operation begins, the table is being tilted, and the tool is now free to go into the helmet without collision. And after the operation is finished, it went through the ear geometry on that left side over here and out of the helmet so that it does not collide with the walls of the part. Okay, that's all I have for today. Thank you for watching. We would love for you to give us a like and a subscribe. Until next time, see you later. Bye-bye.